Zalansky goes back and taking a whack at Zalansky was Terry Karkner. They're using the sticks here late by the Flyers. Penalty coming up. Acton and Callender, they're going to go or not? Here come the Penguins and shooting at Zalansky. A stop made. Acton and Callender, the penalty's going to be against the Flyers. And the fight breaks out. The Flyers want blood right now. They want to establish the tone for the game, and they are just whacking everybody in sight. Mellenby and Jimmy Johnson apparently are going to go to it. There at center ice, Ronnie Finn trying to break it up. Carter came out and whacked about three pins. Acton came out and used the stick. And the Flyers are really going to use the muscle here late in the game. Johnson trying to protect himself. Mellenby is rammed against the boards. Carter's been ushered out of the ice surface. Now somebody's got a hold of one of the pins over on the far side. It's Acton. Jimmy Johnson and Mellenby really going to it now. Mellenby the bigger man. There's no question about that. And Jimmy Johnson hanging tough. And they try and pry him apart. Pens have Kevin Stevens out here and Derek Smith. Jimmy Johnson and Big Mellenby going to it. Now Carter came up. He whacked about three of the pens along the way. All the way up the ice surface. And then Acton right from the faceoff took a stick and rammed it into Jock Callender. Now who's involved here? Cunningworth with the pens and Acton and Poulin. Where's Acton at? No, he's in there. Acton's in there. Let him go. Let him get out there against somebody. Let Acton get away. Let somebody talk to him. Cunningworth and Acton having words. Acton pried apart now by Gordy Brassiker. It was interesting. Acton started so much of that coming up. Went right from the faceoff. Acton. And then it was Karkner ramming goaltender Tom Barrasso. He took a shot at him. He had hit about three Penguins on the way up. But Acton was the guy that set the tone right from the faceoff. He and Callender at center ice. Acton just whacked him three times with a stick. And then hit anything in sight going up and hit him again back in. So the Flyers were to get involved here in the final seconds of play of this game. There's no question about that. Parker's gone. Where's Barrasso at? He's over to get some water. Mellamy gets a 5-minute major for fighting. Chikrin, two for slashing. And Karkner gets two for charging, two for elbowing. Jimmy Johnson of Pittsburgh, a five for fighting. Flyers are going to pick up all the penalties. They're going to put them shorthanded by two men here. And it just was pretty obvious that they came out there on that shift looking for anything that moved. They were going after everybody. The Canadians have home ice advantage. Brown against Acton. This ought to be interesting. They'll drop the puck, and now there's Acton whacking Brown again with that stick. I'll tell you, I'd go after him too, and they do. They go after Acton. He used that stick on Robbie Brown right from the faceoff, and the Penguins didn't take too kindly to it. Now they're going to belt him around. And they're all in. Now Ray gets in, and Barrasso watches the play. He doesn't want to get... Oh, a left by Buskus on Reagan, and he's got him in trouble. Acton's the guy that got it all going again. Boy, did Rod Buskus ever whack Reagan with a left hand. Now Murphy and Zalapsky go to it. Two big boys. They're rolling on the ice. Brown is watching on. Acton and Cunningworth, that'll be a good goal there. Let him go. Reagan's got his stuff off now, and he wants a piece of somebody. Reagan's involved. He won't be playing on Thursday anyway. Cunningworth and Acton. Brown has Reagan held from behind. Stevens in there also, and now Zalapsky is on top of one of the Flyers. Jay Wells also involved. And Zalapsky has his arms wrapped around one of the Flyers. Gordy Murphy. Well, they took exception finally to what Acton was doing. And he is still in there again. I'd go look for him too. Here's Cunningworth and Acton. Randy Cunningworth and Keith Acton and Van Helleman trying to pry them apart. Stevens is going off the ice. Everybody's going to be tossed out here. We may see Hextall back again for the final 9 seconds. Buskus now involved with Reggett. And Wells now trying to get at Tom Barrasso, the Penguin goaltender. And Hextall has to come out another time. And the crowd will sense that. And Ronnie, you got to put him back on, buddy, and go out. Reggett came in and joined the parade, jumped in. Brown pulled him off, and then Buskus and Reggett got in it, and Reggett really took a couple of shots from Rod Buskus. Jay Wells then jumped in on Buskus, and Stevenson came and joined the altercation. And where was Acton? He went unscathed again. I love him. He got it all going. Then he went out the back door. Now I see Tim Kerr still on the ice. Hextall does not want to go back in until things are sorted out, and I can't blame him. He'll be the center of attention here back in the net. What's going to take a long time now is just the announcement on the penalties. Well, Hextall's making the skate over now. And he'll have this crowd fired up. We still have a long way to go. Here we go on the penalty. Oh, no, he just made the announcement that Hextall is back on the net. And we're going to be a delay here because it's going to take quite some time for the penalties to be sorted out by Andy Van Helleman. And what'll be issued? Now come at the 19:51 mark. It's 5-on-3 still for the Pens. Penalties never were announced, and we won't have them until after the game. But it evens out where the Penguins have a two-man advantage still. Sextall's back in the net. 9 seconds left. Penguins win the draw, and they will win game number 5 of this best-of-7 series. 3 seconds to go. Final score, the Penguins 10, the Flyers 7, and it's on to Philadelphia on Thursday night for game number 6 between these two teams, an opportunity for the Penguins to close it out against the Philadelphia Flyers.